Welcome to episode 4 of How to Reinvent. I'm Jill, the content manager and strategist for Reinvent.
And I'm Annie. I'm the head of creative and customer experiences for our global events team. So Jill, welcome back to How to Reinvent.
Episode 4.
We've got 3 episodes that are already available for folks to go back and watch. If they haven't already, they can go to the Reinvent site and they can catch those episodes.
Yeah.
But today we're going to talk about some of the highlights at Reinvent of our diversity and inclusion activities that are happening throughout the week.
Exciting topic.
So we want to make sure we leave plenty of time for that. But before we dive into that, we've been getting a lot of questions about the content catalog, the session schedule, and reserved seating. Can you help walk our viewers through the timing of when those things are going to be coming out and what they can expect?
For sure. So right now, the session catalog is live. The early version of it went live on July 10th. There's roughly just over 200 sessions in there right now. Just titles and abstracts. We want to give people an idea of all the cool things they're going to see at Reinvent. But we will be adding to the session catalog weekly from here until the session catalog gets set in October.
Okay.
So people should check back every week to see what's new, to favorite things, and kind of decide what they want to do.
Okay. So what about reserved seating? When can folks start to really lock in their schedule
Sure.
for Reinvent?
Sure. So over the next several weeks, the content team and I will begin really locking in on sessions. And then we will begin the process in early September of scheduling all of the sessions. We'll have probably over 1,500 sessions this year. And as you can imagine, it takes a while to get all of those sessions scheduled.
Yes.
Especially across 5 venues.
Yes. I've learned when you are in that mode, you've got your headphones on, and it's pretty much
don't talk to me.
So I'll make sure I leave you alone those few weeks.
Yeah. Thank you. So we should have this session catalog pretty much scheduled by the end of September. So what we want to do, what we'll do at that point, late September, early October, is make the full session schedule available to all of our attendees. They won't be able to reserve a seat yet, but we want to give them plenty of time to really dive into the session schedule, mm-hmm. decide what they really want to do. That now they'll know if 2 sessions they're interested in are at the same time, so they can see if one of those sessions has a repeat later or earlier in the week. So just to really dive deep into the session catalog, make strategic decisions, and then be prepared for when reserve seating really goes live, which will happen a little bit later in October. As soon as we set that date, we'll send out plenty of communication so everyone knows the exact date and time when reserve seating goes live. But when it does, then you can log in and basically start scheduling everything you've already favorited, so that it is an easy and simple process.
It's like back in the day when we had to like plan out our college.
It's exactly like these classes
are my top choices. Uh-huh. This is the other time that mm-hmm. it can be offered, and you can kind of plug and play.
Yep.
What we are telling customers and what we have really found is like a little bit of pre-planning goes a long way in terms of having a successful week at Reinvent.
Yep, exactly.
And to kind of go along with that, one of the things that my team is developing is a worksheet to help guide customers through how to think about their priorities at Reinvent. So we've talked a little bit in the episodes before this of how much is going on.
Mm-hmm.
And coming in with a plan of like, hey, what are my top priorities? What do I want to learn about? What kind of learner am I? We've talked about our hackathon program.
Yep.
And we've talked about boot camps. So sort of balancing out breakout session content with some more hands-on content like workshops or chalk talks. And then also sort of figuring out what their non-breakout and content strategy is too. Yeah, and you want to make sure that you're leaving time for networking and visiting the partner expo and going to the pub crawl and all of those things. And so we will be releasing that worksheet to go along with that planning process that you're talking about in September, where you can really sort of think about your priorities for the week. It's also a great way at the end of the event to show it to your boss and say, hey, these were my priorities going into the event and look at all the great things that I accomplished that week.
Yeah.
So now that we've covered that, we've got some very special guests this week. We actually have 2 guests. We have Abby Fuller, who's from our evangelism team, mm-hmm. and we have Sasha Thompson, who's from our diversity team, and they're going to come out and talk about some of the things that we're doing both at Reinvent, but AWS is doing a lot of other things.
Yep.
So Sasha in particular will talk about that.
Yeah.
Great.
So Abby and Sasha, welcome to How to Reinvent.
Thank you.
We're super excited you guys are here today, and we'd like to have you both introduce yourselves. So Sasha.
Sure. My name is Sasha Thompson. I am the Inclusion Marketing Lead for Amazon Web Services, and I manage the We Power Tech program.
Cool. I'm Abby. I am one of the technical evangelists here at AWS.
So Sasha, we're here today to talk about some of the activities that we're doing at reInvent. But obviously, we do a lot of work year-round with the We Power Tech program. So why don't you give us a little bit of an overview of what that program is and what you guys are doing?
Sure. So We Power Tech was started last year, 2017, as our diversity and inclusion outreach program. And so it's kind of our marketing effort to make sure, well, two things. One, to increase the number of underrepresented people that are trained in AWS. And so we work K-12 through working professionals and really making sure that we build a pipeline of diverse tech talent. And so we do that. We have partnered with about 70 organizations globally to do that. We tie them into all kinds of aspects of AWS. So AWS Educate, training and certification, our startups team, kind of whatever team internally is really interested in reaching diverse tech talent. Okay. And then the second part is our speakers bureau. And so making sure that those individuals have a voice and are seen. And so we tie that back to the summits and to some of the other things that we do within AWS, like reInvent, but also third-party conferences as well, too. So there are often other folks that are looking for diverse tech talent to talk on certain topics. And so our speakers bureau does that.
That's amazing.
Very cool.
So why don't we talk a little bit about what you're doing the week of reInvent, some of the activities that are happening there.
Yep, sure. So we are continuing what started last year with the three sessions on diversity. So we're doing one on women. We're doing one about being an ally. And then we're also doing one touching on intersectionality,
which is a new topic we're hitting this year.
Maybe you could explain like sort of what people could get out of each of those three sessions for people who may not be familiar with what some of those topics may cover.
Yep, sure. So for the women's session in particular, we will look at just all of the topics that touch women in technology, some of the challenges and some of the ways that we can work together to get better in this industry. And so that one in particular, we look at all types of women. So we look at race and gender, but we also look at, you know, other things as well in that particular topic. For the intersectionality piece, we really look at the ways that people fall into different minority groups and how those issues touch them, right? Yeah. So you may have someone that is a Black male that is gay. Right. Some of the issues that he would have is very different than a white female lesbian or transgender woman. Mm-hmm. So we're really trying to mix it all up and really have some of those conversations.
Cool.
And understand, you know, all of these issues are different, but how we as an industry can come together to support our employees and our customers that fall into those spaces.
That's great.
And then the other one is the ally one. And so really that one is going from how do you go from being an ally to an advocate and really providing the tools that people would need to be able to do that and take those back to their companies and be able to incorporate those in their day-to-day lives.
Yeah, that's great. And all of those are super important topics. I know I have been pushing, you know, in my personal life and my professional life on people to do more and say more. So it's great for people to really have a chance to educate themselves on how they can do more. Because I know a lot of people actually really do, but maybe they're not sure how to start or what to do. And so it's great that we're helping show leadership in this area by giving people some guidance on how to do those things.
Yeah, and we really want to build it as a community, right? So that kind of goes into the happy hour and the reception that we're doing. This year, we're doing one big reception. And so we want to make sure that people have the opportunity to network and meet other folks and enjoy each other's company, but then also the allies and advocates and everyone else. So one big celebration. And then we'll have our booth also.
That's great.
And so with the booth, we're going to continue that as well to talk about our programs, talk about what we're doing throughout the year, ways that people can join this community. And so we're constantly building and growing our program. And so we're actually going global. We've talked about that. And so making sure that people can figure out ways to connect with us.
And so when you say the booth, the AWS booth, which is in the expo at the Venetian, so we'll have a We Power Tech area where folks can come talk to folks on your team and learn more.
Exactly.
Great. So, Abby, let's transition over to you. Why don't you talk a little bit about what some of your efforts are and what you're doing both at reInvent and beyond?
Yeah, so I've just been trying to amplify the message, I think, a little bit that's coming from the We Power Tech program, because I think we have to set a good example for representation, right? So the more mm-hmm. we want to, and it's not just about waiting for people to come to us. It's mm-hmm. about reaching out and making sure that we have a diverse pool and that anyone that wants to have their voice out there can get their voice out there. So encouraging people to submit topics for reInvent, and then beyond reInvent, that's what makes up the Diversity Speakers Bureau, so the We Power Tech Bureau. And that's for summits, it's for dev days, it's for builders days. But if you want to have your voice heard telling an AWS story, we want to make sure that we can get that.
And then there are a couple other activities that aren't specifically We Power Tech, but that are happening at reInvent that have to do with inclusion and diversity. Can you tell us about those?
Yeah. So seeing mothers' rooms, mm-hmm. Seeing quiet spaces. So people have used those for reflection and meditation, and just reInvent can be a little overwhelming. And sometimes we just need a little bit of quiet time. We did all gender restrooms.
We have the pins as well. Yes. So we have pronoun pins.
That's new this year, I think, right?
No, we've been doing those for the last few years.
Cool.
So this will be our third year. We were actually one of the first conferences that offered the gender pronoun pins for people
awesome.
To select and put on their lanyard. And that way other folks know the right pronoun to use. Yeah.
And then also related, I think, to the Ally session that you guys are doing, we are also kind of implementing this Ally's tips and tricks in our monthly newsletter, right?
Yes.
Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, sure. Cool. So every month we'll have a new tip in
awesome.
There. And so it's an opportunity to kind of make sure people have some ideas of what they can do if they see something that's going quite not the way that it's supposed to at the conference, but it's really bringing the code of conduct to life.
Cool.
Yeah. So we have a code of conduct at reInvent that we expect everyone to follow, whether mm-hmm. it's our employees, our customer speakers, our vendors have to agree to follow the code of conduct. It's something that's very important to us. And through these tips and tricks in the newsletter, one, it just reminds people of what the expectations of behavior are.
Yeah.
We do have very high expectations of what the proper behavior is at a conference that makes everyone feel safe and included and welcomed, but then also how to maybe be those eyes and ears for all of us,
exactly.
right? So someone might overhear something or see something, and we want them to know how to handle those situations, how to get in touch with AWS security, whatever it is, but we really want to just call attention to it, because it's not enough, I think, to have a code of conduct if you're not talking about what the expectations are and you're not reminding people what they are. And so this news, the tips and tricks in the newsletter is one way that we are doing that.
And then we're also trying to do kind of a better job of getting ideas from people, not just for content, but for reInvent in general, ways we can be more inclusive or, you know, more fun or quirky ideas and events. So can you guys let us know kind of how you're tackling that?
Yeah, I think the theme here for all of this, right, is that we want you to know that we're listening.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Whether it's an idea for a topic or something that you saw that was against the code of conduct, we're here and we're listening. And I think the same thing goes for what else can we do or what else can we do better? So if you have an idea for an extracurricular that we're not doing or that we haven't thought about, or, hey, maybe you could do this more often, let us know. So you can let us know on Twitter. I'm at Abby Fuller. You can send it to wepowertech@amazon.com. Anything that I get, by the way, I just send to.
I just send over.
I also just send to Sasha. So it all goes to the same place. It's just many ways to get the information across. And then something else that I think we want to add is that every year there's so many cool kind of unofficial things. So like special interest groups or affinity groups, and they're meeting and they're kind of spreading it by word of mouth. But we're also happy to amplify that and to give you what resources we can to help.
And our team is too. We're happy to put it on the website, in the mobile app, however we can help these affinity groups meet up and see each other.
Yeah.
We want to help facilitate that.
Yeah. Great. Yeah.
Cool.
All right. Well, one of the things that we ask all of our guests are your tips and tricks for surviving the week of reInvent. Abby, I know you've done several reInvents, so why don't we start with you? What are your tips and tricks for surviving the week?
I have so many. the first one is batteries and chargers.
Yes.
You can almost always find people, though, camped out in the hallway, plugging into the wall outlets.
Mm-hmm.
So don't always count on finding the outlet. Bring the external battery and your own cable. It's way faster, and then you can carry it around. Also, give yourself time to get between places. So it can be really difficult to get between casinos. The Vegas Strip is huge. And the first time that I'd ever gone to Vegas was for reInvent a couple years ago. And I'm always thinking, of course I can get there in 15 minutes. And I could not, in fact, get there in 15 minutes. So I apologize to everyone for the dinners I've been late to, the sessions I was almost late to. So give yourself plenty of time, even with the shuttle. Just if you're going to jump between venues, just patience and know that it's farther away than it looks.
Yeah. And Sasha, what about you?
So this is my first official reInvent, but I've actually been to Vegas like 5 times last year for other work-related things. And so comfortable shoes is number one.
Yes,
so
for
I have,
sure.
I think, maybe 4 different kinds of Crocs that, well, no, they're very fashion forward.
Okay.
Make sure of that.
I'm going to need some sort of picture of these.
I need some visual proof. Unscripted webinars here, folks.
Yes. But definitely comfortable shoes, water, making sure you stay hydrated, and just kind of getting your schedule set, you know, and making sure you know where you're going. Because to your point, you know, things look short on a map, and then it takes a little bit longer to get there.
Yeah. I think, too, it's not always about the sessions and the formal kind of activities. That some of the best conversations I've had at reInvent have been in the hallway or in line at the Starbucks. And things go up online, too. So if you find yourself in the middle of like this really cool networking conversation, it's okay to do that. And that's part of what makes reInvent awesome, is that there's so many people. Like, I see coworkers that I haven't seen in a year, because everyone kind of flies in for that. So make time for kind of the networking and the human part of it, too.
Yeah.
It's not just breakout sessions. It's about just kind of meeting and being with your peers.
Well, and to save battery life, maybe put your phone away and have those conversations in the Starbucks line. I know I'm guilty of that as well. But, you know, maybe don't run your battery down by putting it away when you're standing in line for a breakout or standing in line at
then
Starbucks.
Then you get two people's tips. Yeah,
exactly. All right, so Jill, what about you? Words of wisdom this time.
Yes. So I think kind of based on our many discussions today, understanding the campus map and where things are on the campus, the north side of the campus versus the south side of the campus, which venues are super walkable between each other. Like, you can get from the Venetian to the Mirage really easily, between the ARIA and the Bellagio really easily. And when you're starting to kind of plan your time, plan your sessions, plan your day, kind of focus on making things a little more walkable, because then you spend less time on a shuttle and more time in breakout sessions.
I would personally like an entire webinar on how Jill gets in between venues so quickly. You definitely seem to have a list of here's how I can get there quickly, and I need that. I need that webinar.
All right, great.
Just personally,
we can probably do that. What about you?
Well, Jill, I am an introvert, so I know, you know, talk show hosting aside, I do need my time at reInvent to sort of take a break, have a little bit of time to myself, whether it's, I like to sometimes find an hour before, like, the evening activities, like, there's that little lull sometimes between the end of the day and the evening activities. Find a wine bar. I never like to say where my places are, because then I'm afraid they're going to be overrun, but I do have my secret spots. So find your wine bar, have a nice glass of Pinot, find the little beer garden, have your IPA there, and really just have that time to unwind and recharge your batteries a little bit, maybe not speak to any humans, and then you can go back into reInvent and be social and network.
That's a good one.
Well, thank you so much for being here. We're super excited to have you guys on the calendar. It took a little bit of rescheduling, but we're really happy. We are really happy that we could make it work.
Yep.
We love having you ladies here. So thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Yeah. And we've got another episode next month. We've got some community heroes coming on.
Yep.
We might have a special appearance by one of our famous AWS bloggers. So we're really excited about that. So thanks for watching, everyone. And you can catch us next time.
Thanks.